In this recording, we would like to present a feature that we consider a SaaS competitive advantage in the data quality solution market. This is our SaaS quality knowledge base, known as the QKB. The quality knowledge base spans the spectrum of all the SaaS runtime capabilities. Our data quality features can be accessed in any of these environments, from real-time data out to the edge. The SaaS data quality knowledge base supports customization tools that are available to all customers through support.sas.com. Data and logic in the QKB are organized into a set of definitions that span 40 countries, 28 languages, and over 40 locales and 10 definition types. There are over 3,000 definitions available. The definitions might contain data and logic used to determine the gender of an individual's name or their address. There are vocabularies and grammars available to you. You can use the capabilities provided by SAS, or you can customize them through our customized tool. The customized tool is available to everyone who purchases the SAS data quality capabilities. Once you create your own custom solutions, they get published out as your own custom quality knowledge base, and then you can deploy it into your enterprise. Now I'm going to show you how you can leverage our data quality capabilities through batch and in real time. This is showing how our desktop functions allow you to perform gender analysis, which is just one of the data quality capabilities we support. In this case, we're selecting different tokens to apply gender analysis to. You can preview the results here, and you can see that we have identified the gender. And this can be applied across many different languages. If this is a function that I want to make available in a real-time environment, I can publish this function out and leverage it in various real-time services. So, for example, I can map up this function to a real-time REST interface in our data management server, and then using that real-time function, I can apply data to it. This will then allow me to perform lookups into the data quality function from a REST interface. This can be used from web applications or anywhere you can call a REST-based API. Notice how easy it is to switch from batch to real-time data quality, which allows you to leverage the capabilities in any environment. We can also call data quality functions from SQL using our SQL capabilities. These functions are mapped and published in the data quality environment. You can see as we drill down, there are all the different data quality functions available to you in SQL. We support pushdown SQL, which means that we will run these right inside your database, which means we're not moving the data, it's just performing those functions in the database, which saves performance and allows you to leverage them where your data lives. You can run the same data quality functions in your ETL product. This is SAS Data Integration Studio, which is our ETL product. It allows you to leverage any of those published functions or any of the functions that are available to you that are in the data quality environment from your ETL jobs. This is showing you how you can apply standardize across your data functions. You can use our out-of-the-box capabilities, or you can create your own capabilities and call them from your ETL functions. We can also call those same real-time services that we published from our ETL job easily by just mapping up the inputs to that published data quality function in our ETL job. So here we're mapping up gender analysis to call it. Another very nice feature of our data quality capabilities is that they can be embedded in the database to run on your data. I mentioned this before, but this demonstration is showing you how you can run this on your data in Hadoop, which is particularly useful given that Hadoop is often the realm of very large data. By publishing our data quality functions into the database, we can easily apply things like cleansing, gender analysis, address parsing, standardization, and other capabilities directly on your data in Hadoop. Here we're showing the results of that gender analysis on the Hadoop data. You can run our data quality functions in SAS Studio, which is our programming environment. Here we're showing all of the different data quality functions that are available to you. It's those same data quality functions, including the ones that you may have customized yourselves using our quality knowledge base tools. It's easy to use them. We deliver a set of code that allows you to call them, that helps you. These are code templates that help you call these functions. You then just map up your inputs to the data and run it. Same type of capability. This is that gender analysis, and it's being performed on your data in this runtime environment. Data quality can also be run out on the edge. Here we have an event stream coming in. This is using our event stream engine. So for example, we can apply data quality cleansing functions, parsing functions, and standardization functions to data as it's flowing through the stream. Here you can see how we're using identification analysis to pull out parts of that stream and identify the content that's in there. We're applying here the contact info function in the stream to extract contact information. Name, address, phone number, and those kinds of capabilities. We can standardize that content. So if it's a state, we can standardize the state names. We can clean phone number fields or zip code fields, country codes, address fields, parse those elements out, perform gender analysis, all on the data as it's flowing through the stream. This allows us to take data quality all the way out to the edge and apply data quality functions where the data is coming in from this stream. Here we're performing some identification analysis to note that we have address information in the stream, state province information, and other kind of data.
We are in SAS Intelligent Decisioning, where we wanted to use the SAS QKB, the SAS Quality Knowledge Base. Within Intelligent Decisioning, we can use the Quality Knowledge Base in rule sets. When we open the rule set, we then can call the QKB functions by adding a new statement. We are going to the rule editor, and here we set the statement. We want to generate, in this example, a match code and move the match code into the variable name underscore MC. We double click to pass the variable name over. This editor is written in a way that most things can be simply clicked together without typing much to help people with little or no coding knowledge. Then we need a data quality function, a QKB function. Therefore, we click on the tab function where we see a list of all available functions in intelligent decisioning, grouped in categories. For us, relevant here, the data quality category, where we get a list of all data quality functions. There are over 30 data quality functions for 10 subcategories like matching, parsing, standardizing. And here we can now fill in the parameters for the DQ match function by setting the name. So we double click the name and it passes this over. We want to do this for the QKB definition name to tell the QKB that these are name values. We also have to set a sensitivity to say how strong the match code should match the real value. And we have to set a locale, and we set this to EN for English and USA for the country. And this will generate a match code and pass it into the variable name underscore MC. Once we have done this, we now have a rule set that where we can use our match code. Here we have the match code for MC, which we had prepared already, and compare this to our match code for name. And if these two values match, we then standardize the value for name and put it into the field name STND, and therefore we use another data quality function for this. We can then test our rule here within intelligent decisioning. In the test, we see that we have input values. We have then for the input values, Bob and Mac Myler as first name and last name. And the value of name is Robert J. McMiller, all in lowercase. We want that these two and this will match, and then that it will standardize this value. And if we run the rule and look at the output, we will see that it has matched and that this value here from name has been standardized to Robert J. McMiller.
Our data quality functions also perform or form the foundation of our artificial intelligence capabilities that we support in our SaaSvya platform. In this case, we can use those functions to identify problems in your data and make recommendations, which we call suggestions. For example, we've identified that you need to standardize some data in here. This is using data models and the components of and the elements of our data quality solution to perform these analysis. Here you can see that we've identified objects that are in this data stream, phone numbers and addresses, and we're recommending that you standardize them. We will also inspect that data as a part of our AI capabilities and select the appropriate definition for that type of data when you go standardize. So you can standardize addresses and phone numbers and dates. All of these different definitions are available to you, postal codes across those 40 different languages in various locales. Here you can see that we pulled out content from a set of data and identified it. We also allow you to embed our data quality functions in Python. SAS provides a Python interface called SWAT that allows you to integrate SAS, the SAS runtime, in through Python. Those same data quality functions are available to you in the Python environment. So, for example, you can see that we have picked out various functions and separated them out using our data quality capabilities. From this, we want to select create match codes so that we can create the clusters of data that represent the same information and then select a surviving record. Once we've clustered that data, using your Python capabilities and our data quality functions, we can then select, using our data quality functions, the best record that represents your data, the surviving record. This allows you to use all of our data quality capabilities in your language of choice, in this case, Python. We also support R-based interfaces to SAS. And the data quality functions are accessible through that as well. Finally, the data quality functions also form the foundation for profiling your data in our SAS information catalog. In our SAS information catalog, you can see that we have data that we have profiled using our data quality functions. In here, we then go through that data that we have profiled, and we can tell you lots of information that we've discovered. For example, we've detected sensitive information in this data set. You can drill in to see details of your data. You can see that we've identified a semantic type. We've recognized a privacy of this data. We also can do gender analysis, and we've detected that this is a gender-based field. Just to summarize, the SAS Quality Knowledge Base is a differentiating feature for SAS. It provides access to data quality functions throughout the entire SAS stack of runtime environments that you have available to you and throughout the analytic lifecycle.